An Academy. Let's crack it.
Hey everyone, today I am back with another very amazing and interesting question from the house of trigonometry, in which we are being given that cos of alpha minus 3 theta upon cos cube theta is equal to sine of alpha minus 3 theta upon sine cube theta is equal to m, and we have to find the value of m square plus m cos alpha. That would be equal to how much? So the time allotted maximum for this question would be 16 minutes, and ideally you should try to do it within 7 minutes. So you can pause the video, try the question out yourself, and then return back to have a look at the solution. So I hope you all have returned back. Now let us discuss as to how this question can be solved. So the answer of this question, first of all, would be 2. Okay, 2 is the correct answer. Now concepts and formulas used would be cos alpha a minus b and sine a minus b expansion formulas. We should know very basic formulas. Cos a minus b is equal to cos a cos b plus sine a sine b. Sine of a minus b is equal to sine a cos b minus sine b cos a. Similarly, we should also know 2 sine square theta can be written as 1 minus cos 2 theta. Sine 2 theta can be written as 2 sine theta cos 2 cos theta. So basically, these are basic formulas, right? So sine 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta. Similarly, 4 cos cube theta can be expressed in terms of cos theta and cos 3 theta. Similarly, sine cube theta can be expressed as in terms of sine theta and sine 3 theta as mentioned here. Now, what we are going to do as the very first step is we are going to cross multiply in this equation. So cos of alpha minus 3 theta would come out to be m cos cube theta, and sine of alpha minus 3 theta comes out to be m sine cube theta just by cross multiplication. Now squaring and adding, what would we get? So the thing is cos square plus sine square would give us 1. And here we will be able to take m square as common. Inside we'll get cos power 6 theta plus sine power 6 theta, right? Now the thing is that cos square plus sine square whole cube, when we do, we get cos power 6, okay, plus sine power 6 plus 3 into sine square into cos square into sine square plus cos square. But sine square plus cos square is actually equal to 1. So clearly the value of this thing, cos power 6 plus sine power 6, can be written as 1 minus 3 sine square cos square. So that is exactly what, when we have divided it by this quantity, m square comes out to be 1 upon 1 minus 3 sine square cos square theta using this concept, this formula, right? Now what we have done is we have multiplied and divided by 4. So 4 into 1 comes out 4, then 4 into 1 again is 4. Now what is 4 into sine square theta into cos square theta? From here, we are easily able to observe that it would become sine square 2 theta. So that's what we have written here. It becomes sine square 2 theta. Now we are multiplying it by 2 and dividing it by 2. So 4 into 2 is 8, then 4 into 2 is again 8. And 2 sine square 2 theta, I am writing using this formula. It will become, look, 2 sine square x is equal to 1 minus cos 2x. In this case, the x itself is 2 theta, right? So basically cos of twice of 2 theta it would become. So 1 minus cos of 4 theta it has become. Okay. Basically in this formula, I've simply replaced theta by 2 theta. And that's how we got 2 sine square 2 theta, 2 theta value as 1 minus cos 4 theta. So on rearranging, we get this thing. Now, since m square is equal to this thing, we cross multiply and we get 3m square cos 4 theta is equal to 8 minus 5m square. So this is the equation number one that we have marked. Now, when we expand this formula, cos of alpha minus 3 theta formula, we get this quantity, because cos a minus b formula we have applied, and that is already equal to m cos cube theta. Obviously, that we have already obtained. And if we expand this also, what do we get? Sine alpha cos 3 theta minus sine 3 theta cos alpha is equal to m sine cube theta. These we are calling as equations number 2 and 3. Now comes the most important part, and probably the most the trickiest part as well of this entire question. The trickiest part is that since in the question we require cos alpha, so from these two equations we are going to eliminate sine alpha. Basically, you should think of it like two equations in two variables, sine alpha and cos alpha, right? Sine alpha and cos alpha are the two variables in which these pair of linear equations are given to us. Like that, if you think, the question becomes very easy. So we just have to eliminate sine alpha and have to find the value of cos alpha. That is exactly what we are doing. So how can we do that? Very easy. Equation number two, you can multiply by cos 3 theta, and equation number three, you can multiply by sine 3 theta, and you can subtract very easily. If that is something you find difficult, You can do another thing. You can apply Cramer's rule. If that is something you find difficult, you can also apply substitution method. Basically, sine alpha value you find from this equation, sine alpha value you also find from this equation, and equate those two values. Then also sine alpha gets eliminated. So it is up to you. But we have followed this method. So this is very easy method that we have followed, because if you multiply equation 2 by cos 3 theta and equation number 3 by sine 3 theta and then subtract, you will clearly get cos alpha will come out common. Look, sine alpha terms will already get cancelled. And inside of cos alpha, this expression will come, cos square 3 theta plus sine square 3 theta. Here on the right hand side, when we take m common, inside we'll be left with cos cube theta into cos 3 theta minus sine cube theta into sine 3 theta. Okay. Now, we are going to multiply both sides of this equation by 4. On doing that, here we obtain 4 cos alpha, because this is clearly equal to 1, cos square plus sine square. And here, 4 when multiplied by cos cube theta will give us, what is 4 cos cube theta? It is equal to cos 3 theta plus 3 cos theta. So that is exactly what we have written here in place of 4 cos cube theta. Similarly, we'll also obtain 4 sine cube theta. 4 will also get multiplied by sine cube theta. So 4 sine cube theta we have replaced by this quantity, 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta. Okay, but there was also a negative sign. So when that negative is sent, it becomes sine 3 theta minus 3 sine theta. Now it is very obvious to us that cos 3 theta into cos 3 theta would give us cos square 3 theta. Sine 3 theta into sine 3 theta would give us sine square 3 theta. So what is cos square 3 theta plus sine square 3 theta? It is equal to 1. And we take 3 common from these terms. So inside we are left with cos theta into cos 3 theta minus sine theta into sine 3 theta. Now it is obviously the formula of cos A cos B minus sine A sine B. So it would become cos of A plus B. And that is obviously equal to cos 4 theta. So that's how we have obtained this equation number 4. Now, from equation number 4 and equation number 1, we are going to eliminate cos 4 theta. We are going to eliminate cos 4 theta, right? So what I'm doing is, how are we eliminating it? I am multiplying this equation both sides by m, right? So what is m into m going to become? It is going to become m square, right? So 4m cos alpha we have written as it is. Now m square when multiplied by 1 gives us m square, and we get m square into 3 cos 4 theta. So that is obviously 3m square cos 4 theta. Now 3m square cos 4 theta value we substitute from equation number 1. What is 3m square cos 4 theta? It is equal to 8 minus 5m square. So that's what we have written here. Okay, now we rearrange, we get 4m square plus 4m cos alpha is equal to 8. And finally, on dividing by 4, we get the value of m square plus m cos alpha is equal to 2 as the final answer. So quite an interesting problem, and a little bit on the lengthier side as well, also a little tricky. And that's what's making it quite a tough problem to solve. But I hope you all enjoyed watching the problem and learned something new. Little bit of a difficult technique you were able to see and understand. Thank you all for watching once again, and make sure you like, comment, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell icon to stay tuned for more such awesome content and never miss an update. Comment down below what you like the most about the solution, and I'll see you all in the next one.